What's happening, YouTube? Josh Tedder here from 6 months later, and today we'll be taking a look at the Google Wi-Fi Home Mesh Router. Now this is a router we previously reviewed in a video 6 months ago, so in this video we'll be doing our in-depth 6 months later review of the Google Wi-Fi router. We'll be taking a look at what makes this router such a great router for any home, big or small, how it improves upon and solves a lot of problems that have plagued users with Wi-Fi routers for years, and we'll take a look at how it's held up after 6 months of use. This is 6 months later. Wi-Fi can be a tricky issue in a lot of households and apartments. For houses, people typically find that their Wi-Fi router struggles to pump out enough signal to cover their entire home with full Wi-Fi signal strength. In apartments, you have the opposite problem. There are so many routers in such close proximity to each other that it causes a ton of interference issues and thus reduces the effectiveness of an individual Wi-Fi router. The Google Wi-Fi Home Mesh routers aim to solve these huge problems in consumer Wi-Fi and much more. I got my Google Wi-Fi router 6 months ago after sadly my Apple AirPort Extreme fried in a lightning storm. So I was already coming from a pretty decent router with great performance. It was great for my residence at least, and it served me well. So when I plugged in my Google Wi-Fi router, I really didn't notice that big of a performance boost or anything since both routers were very good. However, as I started to use the Google Wi-Fi router more, I just noticed how much better of a router it actually was, even compared to what I had before. For example, here's one issue that it solved right off the bat for me. With my Apple router, I had an interference issue with my PlayStation 4 controller when I had a headset hooked into the controller. When I plugged in and started using the Google Wi-Fi, this issue was solved immediately, likely due to one of the best features of the Google Wi-Fi router, which is channel optimization. With channel optimization, the Google Wi-Fi will scan the environment it's in to see what Wi-Fi channels are currently in use, as well as measure other sources of congestion and interference. It will then select the best channel for your Wi-Fi devices to be on. This is great for apartment dwellers with all those routers in close proximity to each other and lots of sources of interference for Wi-Fi routers, and it's also great for other situations like playing a PS4 with a headset plugged into the controller. The best part about this feature with the Google Wi-Fi router is it does it automatically. You don't even have to think about it. That's actually a really good way to think about what living with a Google Wi-Fi mesh network is like. Google just takes care of everything for you. You don't even have to think about it. The way they accomplish this is through good hardware and great software, especially with the Google Wi-Fi app, which is very good. The Google Wi-Fi app has tons of features. For example, it will let you know if your Wi-Fi network is offline or online in the Google Wi-Fi app. Whether you're at home or away on travel, you'll always be able to see the status of your network. The Google Wi-Fi app also allows you to see the devices currently on your Wi-Fi network, which is pretty cool. You can tap into the devices and actually see how much data each device is downloading and uploading on your network. Another great feature of the Google Wi-Fi router app is it allows you to control the brightness of the LED in the Wi-Fi point itself. So if you put your router, for example, behind your TV like I do, and don't want that LED blinding you while you're trying to watch a movie, you can just go into the Wi-Fi point settings within the Google Wi-Fi app and adjust the brightness of the LED. Now, if you're the type of person that forgets your Wi-Fi password or never really has it accessible to give to your friends and family, well, the Google Wi-Fi has you covered there as well. Your Google Wi-Fi network password is always accessible within the app, and it's easy to share to friends and family over a variety of communication methods like texting, email, Facebook Messenger, etc. Another great feature of the app is that you can prioritize specific devices on your Wi-Fi network to give them more bandwidth. I still can't believe how easy it is to do that and a lot of other things within this app, which is great news if you're the type of person who isn't necessarily technical and especially doesn't want to futz around with all of the settings of a router and just wants the thing to work and you get great performance and everything just works really well. Now, this is definitely the case for my parents, who I gifted a 3-pack of the Google Wi-Fi routers to for Christmas. My parents were previously using an ISP router and modem, which in my opinion is a big no-no if you actually want good home Wi-Fi. When we set up the Google Wi-Fi mesh network, they were astounded at the difference it made between what they had previously and what they now have. With the Google Wi-Fi mesh network, not only could they get signal at the opposite end of their house, they now get full bars. In the computer room upstairs, they were lucky before to get maybe 20 or 30 megs down. Now they easily get over 100. The internet speed they were paying for has not changed. That stayed consistent. It is the Wi-Fi performance that has changed significantly for them. Now, one thing my dad really liked about the Google Wi-Fi routers was how easy it was to set up one router and then add in the Wi-Fi points to create a mesh network. And it's always a good thing when you get your parents a tech gift that they can actually set up themselves because it's not overly complex. And I give all that credit to Google. One nice thing that the app does when you set up an additional Wi-Fi point is it will actually tell you if the Wi-Fi point you're setting up is in a good location in your residence and will receive a strong signal from the main router. Now, when you have a Google Wi-Fi mesh network made up of multiple Wi-Fi points, what happens is the Wi-Fi device you're using will just simply connect to the closest Wi-Fi point to it. And the Google Wi-Fis, they all do this automatically. Again, you never have to think about it. Having multiple Wi-Fi points makes a huge difference. I have two in my residence because I needed one next to the window so it could pump out enough Wi-Fi signal to my garage across the street. I have a Wi-Fi enabled garage door opener that simply just wasn't getting enough Wi-Fi signal from the one router I had, but luckily the second Google Wi-Fi point I added to my network fixed that problem immediately. Moving on, let's talk about some more great features with this router. One of my personal favorites is the Google Wi-Fi app allows you to see and manage multiple Google Wi-Fi networks. This is great if you're in my scenario and you've gifted the Google Wi-Fi router to your parents so you can go in and see the status of their network and manage it if need be. Or it's also great if you have multiple homes, you can just go in and manage each home's network and switch in between the two. Now, the Google Wi-Fi app has great admin controls as well. Within a Google Wi-Fi network, there are two types of admins, an owner and a manager. An owner of a Google Wi-Fi network can see the status of the network, change any settings they'd like, as well as they can add, remove, or factory reset Wi-Fi points. A manager of a Google Wi-Fi network can only see the status and change the settings. They cannot do anything to add or remove Wi-Fi points or set anything back to a factory reset. Another great feature that I like about the Google Wi-Fi app is not only can you test the Wi-Fi speed from the router to your device, you can also test the internet speed coming into your home to the router, as well as test the strength of the entire mesh network. Now, one feature of the Google Wi-Fi that parents absolutely love and kids probably hate but will engineer their way around it anyways is called family Wi-Fi. Now, with family Wi-Fi, what you can do is you can group all of your kids' devices that are on the Wi-Fi network together within the family Wi-Fi feature in the Google Wi-Fi app. You can group your kids' devices together and then schedule pauses for the Wi-Fi going out to these devices at specified times, like during bedtime or during dinner. Now, you can also pause the Wi-Fi to your kids' devices at any point in time in case you need to take Wi-Fi away as punishment or for a timeout. And you can, of course, block adult websites to any of your kids' devices with this feature. Creating a guest Wi-Fi network is also incredibly simple with the Google Wi-Fi. All you have to do is decide what you want to name the guest network and the password for the guest network, and then that's it. Google just takes care of the rest. And you don't have to worry about remembering the password to your guest Wi-Fi because it is kept in the app as well. Now, after 6 months of using the Google Wi-Fi home mesh routers, I can't say that I've had any problems at all with them. I've never even had to reboot any of my Wi-Fi points, even once. Now, if you're looking at getting a Google Wi-Fi and are kind of struggling to figure out exactly, do I go with the one pack or do I get the three pack? Here's what I would recommend. If you have anything over 1,000 square feet, I'd at least look at the three pack, but you don't necessarily have to get it. If you've got anything over 2,000 square feet, I'd definitely get the three pack at that point, even if it's still a little bit overkill. One is probably not going to do it at 2,000 square feet, depending on where you actually place the router and where the coax cable is coming into your home. Now, your mileage is going to vary here, and the materials used to construct your home and the type of floor plan you have, that is all going to contribute to how many Wi-Fi points may be necessary for your residence. So for example, if you have a house that has a very open floor plan, you may not need all three Wi-Fi points in your mesh network. But if you have a house that doesn't have an open floor plan, has a ton of rooms, lots of walls, hallways, no open spaces in a basement, you're likely gonna need the three Wi-Fi points. Overall, I can't recommend the Google Wi-Fi home mesh routers enough. They're simple to use, they have one of the best designed apps I've ever seen, they have great performance, give your entire residence full Wi-Fi coverage, and make managing a Wi-Fi network as simple as it should be. The Google Wi-Fi Home Mesh routers start with a single router configuration at $129 US, and the three-pack goes for $299 US. Thanks so much for watching this review. If you liked this video, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this one. Also, be sure to leave a comment below if you have any questions at all about the Google Wi-Fi routers, and if you already own a Google Wi-Fi router, let me know what you think of it. Thanks again for watching. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder.